all the evangelization of St. Paul can be summarized in two words, only two words, in Christ. Everything St. Paul did, everything St. Paul acted, was always in Christ. In Christ we have been baptized, in Christ we died, in Christ we risen, in Christ we received the Holy Spirit, in Christ we received peace, in Christ we became dynamic evangelizers. So there is another aspect very important which can inspire us in evangelization according to St. Paul. The life of St. Paul was a life on move. All his evangelization was a dynamic evangelization. He was moving from place to place, from city to city, town to town, community to community, on move in Christ. St. Paul tells us and inspires us while we are evangelizing that we do need to evangelize in a community, with a community, that our evangelization can be more successful if we do it together. That's why Pope Francis is insisting on this aspect of synodality, of community, of working together, because inspired by the first centuries of evangelization that were the most successful periods of evangelization in the history of the Church, we do need to do it in community, together. And I do believe if we really want to inflame our beautiful country, if we really need to inflame with the presence of the Lord our beautiful country of Slovakia, we do need to evangelize, we do need to work together in community. You know, dear brothers and sisters, concretely this means that we need, in the contemporary context of our evangelization, to put a bit aside the institutional aspect of the Church, and we have to more be centered in the community aspect, in the dynamic aspect of the Church. Of course, institution is very important, but today institution doesn't touch the heart of the people. All the institutions are in crisis, not only the Church institution. We see the governmental institution, we see the public institution, all the institutions in society are in crisis, because institutions, they doesn't touch the heart of the people. So our brothers, our sisters, they need to be involved, and not only to be member of a church, of an institution. They would like to be a person. That's why we need to be close, we need to work together. Otherwise, we create a kind of gap between an institution and a community. This is what also the Vatican Council, the Second Vatican Council, is trying to teach, to start to recover the community dimension of our evangelization. Because people abandon the institutions. We see our church more and more empty. We see our seminaries more and more empty. We see our congregation more and more empty. We do need to recover, to inflame, recovering this walking together, the communitarian dimension of the evangelization, like St. Paul did. So Christ is my life. Christ is everything. Christ inflames my heart and my life. Not an institution. It's Christ who inflames me. And we are here today in this church. You are participating to the conference, not for something, but for someone, to meet someone. Our Lord Jesus Christ, we are in the church not for something, but for someone, for our Lord Jesus Christ. People need to recover this personal dimension, this personal feeling of presence of the Lord in their heart. In the institutions, we have so many things. We miss the heart. We miss the encounter of the people. We do need to be together. We do need to walk together. We do need to let people understand that we are announcing someone. We are announcing a person who can save my life, as Paul did in his evangelization. Our great latest Pope Benedict XVI wrote an encyclical letter, his first encyclical letter, Deus Caritas Est, where he tried to explain that God is not an idea. God is a person. God is really someone who can help me in my everyday life. So when we understand that God is someone who can really help me to overcome the everyday life difficulties, God is someone who really can help me to deal and face with everything I meet in my everyday life, my life can be changed, my life can be transformed. This cannot come from an institution, this can come from a community. To inflame, we do need a community. To inflame, we do need that Jesus is a person who is living in my life. That's why we do not like room, Catholic room temperature. You know, this is what is happening in our church. These Catholics who are room temperature Catholics, not cold, not warm. We do need people who enter in this dynamism of evangelization. So many times Pope Francis, his many homilies, is repeating us, please don't criticize, try to do something. Don't stay in the balcony criticizing what is doing this priest, what is doing this other priest. Try to do something for the evangelization. And you can do something only if you really do everything in Christ. In Christ and on move. If we stand by, we don't do nothing. And also, St. Paul inspired us also on how we have to present the gospel today and how we did at the beginning of the Christianity. St. Paul teaches us something very important. We cannot impose the truth. We can only propose the truth. When he was evangelizing, when he was in Philippi, in Corinto, when he was in this city, the first thing he did was not imposing with an authority the truth. He was only proposing the truth. This is what I propose to you. I'm very touched by the speech and the predication of St. Paul, you remember, in Athens, no? When he was invited in a stadium, in Areopagos, to preach, no? And of course, in this stadium, in this Areopagos, there were so many gods, and finally, he finds the statues of a god who was an unknown god, and he starts to preach the unknown god. So, dear brothers and sisters, that's what we need to preach today, inspired by St. Paul, to preach the unknown god. This unknown god, unfortunately, who becomes unknown more and more, especially to our young generation. But as St. Paul, we are called to serve. We are called to serve, we are called to propose, not to impose. And unfortunately, in the history of the church, we felt many times in the temptation to impose the truth with the power and with authority. This is not possible anymore. We need to recover this aspect that St. Paul had really present in all his predication. The dimension of respect of the others. We have to evangelize believing strongly that Jesus can change and change our life, proposing, not imposing our evangelization, our values, with the respect of all other cultures. We need to recover this culture of dialogue and respect in our evangelization, so we can inflame our beautiful country of Slovakia if really we do promote our values, proposing our values, and of course being witness, credible witness of what we announce with respect and dialogue. Our great Pope Saint John Paul II used to repeat many, many times that today we don't need any more teachers. We have too many teachers. Today we do need witness. People who really is credible when announcing they live what they preach. And this we can do, dear brothers and sisters, if we do together. If we do as a community, if we put aside the institutional aspect, because institution will be more and more empty. We need to be dynamic. We need to be on move. No room temperature. No room temperature. We need to be on move. And thirdly, we do need respect. Because the gospel teach us, and I repeat this a lot in my predication, the gospel teach us that we have to love people. We have to respect people, not according to what they do, but according to what they are. If we want to overcome this word today, you know, we use a lot this word polarization in our society, we do need to start to respect and to love people, not according to what they do or what they don't do, but according to what they are. And they are children of God. They are our brothers and sisters, because we all are children of God. So dear brothers and sisters, we try to announce the gospel, presenting to our young generation, to the world, that Jesus is a person, a real person who can save our life. Jesus lives in communities. Jesus lives when two or three are gathered to pray him. Jesus doesn't live in institutions. So we try to work together, because, as I always repeat, if we work together, we can go far. If we work alone, we can only go fast. And for us, it's not important to go fast. We want to go far. Thank you, because you really feel in your heart the desire to evangelize and to inflame. We can only inflame others if we have a fire in our hearts, because if we don't have fire in our hearts, I cannot inflame anybody.